Right. So previous class we discussed this cascade H bridge, right? My voice is audible.
Yes, sir.
Right. So previous class we discussed this. So we discussed this cascade H bridge. So this can be, the number of levels can be obtained by cascading two H bridge or two or more H bridge modules in cascade. So we already discussed this with symmetrical and asymmetrical DC sources. So all these are isolated DC sources, right? All these are all isolated DC sources. And by using asymmetry, we can increase the number of levels with lesser number of H bridges in cascade. Okay, so either we can use the arithmetic progression, so that is in the ratio of 1:2:3 and so on, or in the geometric progression with binary and trinary. Okay, so that is 1:2:4 and so on, 1:3:9 and so on. So likewise. Okay, so when you're doing that, when you're working with asymmetry, the drawbacks are the switching redundancies will be reduced even though the number of levels are high. Okay, so the main advantage of this cascade bridge with symmetrical are, so these switching redundancies. So these switching redundancies play an important role in reducing the switching losses and equalizing the power distributed by each H bridge. Equalizing the power distributed by each H bridge. Right. So we already discussed this. So we already discussed how each H bridge is fed, right? How each H bridge is fed, right? So we have different applications like PV applications or a motor drive, or in case of we have some applications like active power filter or DSTATCOM, or applications like STATCOM. You might have studied the STATCOM, right? In fact subject, you might have studied this, right? Flexible AC transmission system, you might have studied this STATCOM, SSSC, UPQC, and all those things you might have studied, right? So now, right, so these H bridges usually are supposed to be fed from, right? So that depends on how these H bridges are feeding or how that isolated DC sources are created. So that all depends on the application, okay? So first, if you consider PV, right? So PV means, in case of PV applications, so what we have to do is, so directly, so this H or this is H bridge, right? So this H bridge is fed from a PV source. Okay, so this H bridge is fed from a PV source, right? So that means here you need to connect a PV source. So here also you need to connect a PV source. Okay, in case of STATCOM or DSTATCOM or active power applications, right? So we'll discuss this okay, in later classes. What is STATCOM? And you might have no STATCOM, right? So we'll discuss in later classes what is STATCOM and active power filter. So in that case, okay, so in that case, in STATCOM and DSTATCOM, so there is no real power transfer. Okay, so there is no real power transfer, so only the reactive power transfer is taking place. So these STATCOMs are primarily used to compensate the reactive power so that to maintain the bus voltage at the prescribed reference value, right? So in that application, so these DC sources are replaced with capacitors. So these DC sources are replaced with capacitors, and by using some controllers, we will charge these capacitors. We will charge this capacitor at prescribed or at their reference value, at their reference value. So how to charge that? So that we will discuss, right? How to charge that? So that we will discuss. Okay. right? In case of PV applications, so these are replaced with a PV source, or in case of battery energy storage system, so in such cases, we need to replace with a superconducting or supercapacitor or energy storage element. Okay, so this one is replaced with an energy storage element. In case of reactive power transfer, when there is reactive power transfer, so these are replaced with simple capacitors. In case of motor drive, right? So in case of motor drive, so in that case, both real power and reactive power both transferred, right? So in such cases, we have to use a diode bridge rectifier in case of non-regenerative loads, and a thyristor or a IGBT based rectifier, so in case of regenerative applications, right? So this is, we already discussed this, a simple application, so that is used for a battery, that is used for an electric vehicle application. Okay, so now, right, so this front end, so that is how to feed these H bridges, so when there is a real power transfer, so that is the motor application. So in this case, right, so we have A phase, so this is A phase, this entire thing is A phase, so this is B phase and this is C phase, right? So A phase, so these are H bridges. For suppose here there are actually K cells are connected in cascade, but in figure it is showing three, right? Assume that there are three cells are connected in cascade, right? So there are three cells, so that are connected in cascade, or three H bridges connected in cascade. So this is one, this is two, and this is three. Okay, so you can see on the left hand side, so how these H bridges are fed, right? So how these H bridges are fed, so this is one, this is the primary of the transformer, and this is the secondary, these are the secondaries of the transformer. Okay, so this is primary and these are all the secondary. So each secondary winding is connected to an H bridge, so each secondary winding is connected to H bridge, and after that, so we'll connect a capacitor to filter out the ripples, and that is feeding to a H bridge. Okay, so this kind of arrangement is known as multipulse converters, right? So this kind of arrangement is known as multipulse converters. So we'll discuss this in later classes, what is multipulse converters. So here each three phase, right, so this is three phase bridge rectifier, right? So it is six pulse, so this is another six pulse, okay, and you have another six pulse, so that means the combined output is 18 pulse. Okay, so the combined output is 18 pulse. Clear? In case of real power transfer or applications such as motor drive, so here the H bridges are fed from a multipulse rectifier. The H bridges are fed from a multipulse rectifier. Clear? So one observation we can make is, right, in case of a in case of normal applications like motor, in case of active power filter, STATCOM, or right, or PV applications, its cost is very less. Okay, in case of these STATCOM applications, simple you have some capacitor, right? That means that cost is less. But in case of real power applications or motor drive applications, so this extra thing is required. Okay, so this extra multipulse converter is required. So why it is required? So what are the advantages we will get? So that we will discuss in the next class. Right, just remember this point only right now. Okay, so next we move to the other multi-level inverter. So that is known as flying capacitor multi-level inverter. So we'll get back to the CHB, right, next class. So this is another one, so that is flying capacitor multi-level inverter. So this is for five level, So this is for 5-level case. You can notice that. So here this part is same, right? So this part is similar to a similar to a diode clamped multi-level inverter. So here also for 5-level, you require 4 DC sources. This is 1, 2, 3. 4 DC sources are required. Okay, so 4 DC sources are required. So earlier you have clamping diodes. Earlier you have clamping diodes, but those clamping diodes are now replaced with these capacitors. So these are known as flying capacitors. These are known as flying capacitors. Right. Here each capacitor, this is E, this is also E, and this is E. All these capacitors are E, right? So that means this is already pre-charged. These capacitors already charged with voltage E, right? So that means the voltage here E. So this entire thing, this one and this one, if we add together, so that is E, and this is E, 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 so that is 3E. So this is the structure of a 5-level flying capacitor multi-level inverter, right? So here, in case, right, so this one is complementary with this one, right? So that means switch 1 is complementary to switch 5 in diode clamp. Switch 1 is complementary to switch 5, right? So that means this switch is complementary to this switch. But okay, this S1 is complementary to this one, right? The top one is complementary to the bottom one, and this is complementary to S2, and this S3 is complementary here, and this S is complementary to this one. Clear? You understand the difference? In case diode clamp, so this top one in the upper side and top one in the bottom side, so are complementary, right? So whereas here the top one is complementary to the bottom one. Okay, clear? So, right, so this is 5-level, right? So measuring the voltage between, so this point, so assume this is N and this is A, right? So this is N and this is A. Clear? So this is N and this is A. So here it will get 5 levels, right? So that means this is A and N. So obviously these levels are 0E, 2E, 3E, and 4E, right? If you measure between this A and N. Similarly, if you measure this voltage at this point, if you assume this is 0, so this V is 0, so it will be 2E, E, 0, minus 2E, right? Okay. Same concept, that is pole voltage, so that is unipolar, or you have two voltages and negative voltage. So whereas if you measure the voltage between A phase to the terminal of, or the DC terminal, negative, so in that case you will get only one voltages, so that is unipolar voltages will get, so that is E, 0, E, 2, E, 3, E, and 4, E, right? So already discussed, this S1 is complementary to this one, right? So now the question is, how to get 4E voltage across A and N? How to get 4E voltage across A and N? How to get that? How to get 4E voltage? Which is we need to turn on.
All top switches.
If you turn on this S1, S2, S3, S4, right? So that means this A is connected to this, right? A is connected to this point. So therefore, all 4 DC sources now in connect with series, right? So the voltage across this A and N is 4E. The voltage that a and n is 4e. Clear? Right? So now the question is how to get 3e voltage. How to get 3e voltage?
Sir, S two, S three, S four, sir, S two, S three, S four,
S four,
S two, S three,
S four, S one,
S two, S three, S four,
bottom S one, and bottom S one, and bottom S one.
So bottom S three is obviously off, right? Bottom one, so it's obviously on, right? So when the top switch is off, so that means the bottom switch is on. Right, so to get this voltage, right, to get 3e voltage, we need to turn on this S2, S3, S4. So we need to turn on this S1. So that means we need to turn on this S1 dash. Okay, so that means now A is connected to this point. So A is connected to this point, and so this negative, this is N. So that is connected to here. Now it is connected to N. So how many DC sources, right? So this one, and one, right? So three DC sources will comes into picture, right? So therefore, the voltage is 3e. Clear? How to 2e? How to get 2e voltage? How to get 2e voltage?
Yes, 3S4, sir. Yes, 3S4, sir.
Yes, 4. Right,
and yes, dash, and yes, dash,
S3, S4, this S4 dash, sorry, S3, S4, and S2 dash, S dash, we need to turn on. Right, so how to get E voltage? How to get E voltage?
S4 and S3, S4 and S3,
right? The rest of S3 dash, S2 dash, S1 dash, we need to turn on, so we'll get E voltage. How to get 0 voltage? Voltage. So you turn off all the S1 to S4, so you will get 0 voltage. Clear? You will get 0 voltage. So operation is more or less similar to the switching on and more or less similar to so this diode clamp, right? So more or less similar to diode clamp. Okay. So now if other possibilities, for example, I want 2E. Okay, is there in possibility, right? So what you said is if you turn on 2e, so you trigger the S4 and S2 dash and S1 dash. So options other than this 2e, other than this one, options for this. So other than turning on S3, S4. S2 dash and S1 dash. Is there any options are there to get 2E voltage? Okay, I will give one option, right? On this one, and I will turn on these two, right? Clear? That means I have to turn off this, and I have to turn off this. So obviously, this switch is turned on, right? So that means so this switch is on, and this. So how much voltage you will get? I turned on S1 and S2, right? I turned on S1 and S2. No. Sorry. This S1 is complementary, right? So turn on this switch. Turn on this switch. Okay. Where else? This is off, right? This switch we need to off. This switch we need to off, right? So what is this complementary switches? These two, right? So what is the voltage you will? You will get across B and N. So will you get 2E with that? So will you get 2E voltage with that?
Minus 2E, sir.
B and N. B and N, so how much voltage you will get? So this, if you connect here, right, if you turn on the switch, right, so how much voltage you will get here? If you turn on this one, how much voltage you will get at this point? So if you turn on this upper switch, right, so how much this entire 4 will come, right? So that means this is a potential 4E, right? So what is the potential here? How much voltage you have here? This
2E, sir.
Right? Okay. So now what is the overall voltage? What is the voltage? This is 4E, right? So 2E, right? So that means you will get 2E voltage. Okay. Clear? You will get 2E voltage. Similarly, if you want only E voltage, right, just turn on this one, right, turn off turn off this 4, right, you need to turn on this one and this one, so you will get 2E voltage. Okay, so that meaning is, if you want 4E, right, if you want 4E, you need to turn on all the upper switches. If you want 3E, so you need to turn on any 3 upper switches. If you want 2E, you need to turn on any two upper switches. If you want E, you need to turn on any one upper switch. You can turn on any one upper switch so that you can get the voltage. Switch 4, you need to turn on all the upper switches. To get E, you need to turn on any 3 upper switches. At 2E, you need to turn on any 2 upper switches. For E, you need to turn on any 1 upper switch. So that means 4 possibilities are turn on either S1, S2, S3 or S4. To get 0 voltage, you need to turn off all the upper switches. Right. Therefore, this is what we get, right? This is the voltage between this E. So you have only one possibility for 2E. So you have possibilities. Again for E, so you will 6 possibilities are there. And again, you have this is only one possibility. So you have 4. This is 6 possibilities are there. Again, 4 possibilities, and this is one possibility, right? So for example, E. So that just turn on this S1 and S2. Other combination is S3, S4, and we have this one S2, S3, and we have S1. And S3. Okay. So that is another one. This we have this S2 and S4. That means combinations you have to turn on any 2 upper switches. So that is how in capacitor multiple inverter will work. Right. So here this multi levels are obtained by using this pre-charged capacitors. Right. So obtained with this pre-charged capacitors. Clear? So now how many capacitors? So these are the main capacitors, right? So these are the main capacitors and these are the flying capacitors. You have two group of capacitors are there, right? So this group is the main capacitors. This group is the main capacitors. Okay, so whereas this one, so all these things is the known as flying capacitors. So how many main capacitors you require for M level? You require M minus one main capacitors. Right, so how many flying capacitors you require? How many flying capacitors you require?
Yes. Yes.
How many you require?
N plus one.
If it is N plus level, one. Right, how many you require? So this is right. This is 1, 2, 3, right? So that means total is 6. You require 6 capacitors, right, in phase. So what should be maybe the formula for this?
3M plus 3M plus.
How to write this? How to generalize this? How to generalize this? Will it be something like this? M minus 1 into M minus 2 by 2 per phase. Is this okay? So 5 level, 5 minus 1, that is 4, into 5 minus 2, that is 3. Okay, 4 into 3, that is 12, divided by 2, that is 6. Clear? It's clear?
Yes, sir.
Same way, so how many clamping diodes you require? So we derived this, right? So that you require M minus 1 into M minus 2 clamping diodes are required. So whereas this flying capacitors, same thing, that is M minus 1 into M minus 2, by 2 will come, right? That extra by 2 will come. Clear? So all we are talking about, these things are for phase. If you want to calculate for 3 phase, you need to multiply with 3. But this DC capacitors or this DC main capacitors, so that are common to all the 3 phases. It's clear? So how many switches are required? 2 into M minus 1. 2 into M minus 1 switches are required. But this clamping, but this flying capacitors are M minus 1 into M minus 2 divided by 2. Clear? So this is the same structure, right? This is also same thing, right? So, but it is showing in a different way, right? So it is showing in a different way. So what different way we'll see. Right, so here the earlier structure is something like this, right? So we have this center point. Okay, so this is the structure. Earlier one is like this, right? Okay, what about if you drag here? I will show you. So this is the structure, right? Earlier one. Okay, so whatever, if you pull this one to this side and if you pull this one to the other side, that means if you fold this one, so along that x-axis, right, along this vertical axis, right, so this will form this type of structure. Okay, so this is corresponding to your switch, right? If you assume that 3 switches are there, this is corresponding to switch S1, this is corresponding to switch S2, S3, and this is S3 dash, S2 dash, and S1 dash. So both are same, right? So both are same, just we try to fold it, right? So just we are trying to fold that. Okay. So this is between S3 and S4. So how much voltage? This is S3, right? If we assume this one, right? So we have this capacitor. So this must be charged to E. So this must be charged to 2E, right? Enter this capacitor. So this must be charged to 3E, right? Clear? So that means I just try to fold that one, right? So that means this capacitor, this voltage is E, right? And this voltage is 2E. So when you have other part, right? It may be if you have another cell, right? So this is 3E. The same thing, but the representation is same. This is known as multi-cell representation. Multi-cell representation. Here also it is showing one capacitor, one DC source, right? Actually, in fact, two capacitors are connected in series, so that represents 2E voltage. Okay, so this is cell 1, assumed as cell 1, this is cell 2, and this is cell 3. This is a common DC bus. This is the DC bus. Okay, so this is the DC bus, and you will get this A phase or X phase terminal. Okay, so this is the this is a multi-cell structure for the same flying capacitor. Okay. Just we redrawn this one to show its modularity. Okay, to show its modularity. So this is how this input rectifier is designed for this one. If you're driving, or if it is if it is operated for real power transfers like motor drives. So in this case, right, in this case you require 3 capacitors, right? So that means 3 DC sources, right? So this one is fed from, this rectifier is feeding 1 DC source. These are semi converters, right? Top one I'm shown with the thyristors, and bottom one are diodes, the example that I consider. So these are 3 capacitors. This is feeding this top DC source, middle DC source, and this bottom DC source, and this is fed from a 18 pulse converter. So this is fed from a 18 pulse converter. So why, what is this 18 pulse converter, we'll discuss in the next class. Okay, clear? So this is fed from a 18 pulse converter. So these, normally this multi-pulse converters are used to provide this isolated DC sources. So one of the main applications, which are generally one of the main drawback with this diode flying capacitor, is we need to pre-charge these capacitors. So all these capacitors we need to pre-charge. So that means this capacitor we need to pre-charge to E. So these two capacitors, right, practically these are replaced with only one capacitor, and that must be pre-charged to 2E. If you have 3 capacitors, so that must be pre-charged to 3E. Okay, so that means to start this, or to start this inverter, so before that we need to pre-charge these capacitors. Okay, so we need to pre-charge these capacitors. So that is one of the difficult process. So that is one of the difficult process in this flying capacitor multi-level inverter. Okay, so one of the difficult thing, we need to pre-charge, or we need to initialize the capacitors, or we need to initialize the DC sources. So that is the difficult thing. Okay, and coming to applications, right? So generally, right, to maintain this DC capacitor or this capacitor at prescribed value is very difficult thing, right? So we need to maintain this E, 2E, and 3E. If any variations are there, earlier class we discussed, right? If any variations in the source is there, right, the positive cycle and the negative cycle will be different. Positive cycle, for example, if it is 100 volts, right, it's supposed to maintain at 100 volts. Positive cycle, it is in one capacitor is maintaining at 110 volts, and the bottom one is maintaining at 90 volts, right? So that means you will get a level with 110 volts, and the negative cycle you will get a levels with 90 volts, right? If there is asymmetry is there, so in that case it will cause for DC offset and even order harmonics, right? So therefore we need to strictly maintain its prescribed value. That is E means it's we need to exactly maintain the capacitor voltages so that we can avoid DC offset. Okay, so actually it is difficult to maintain this in actual practice, so therefore its applications are limited. So generally this flying capacitor multi-level inverter is not used, right? So one of the major application, so that is metro rail engine or metro rail applications. Okay, so here we have Delhi Metro is there, right? And we have Hyderabad Metro. The power converter that used is this flying capacitor multi-level inverter. The flying capacitor multi-level inverter is used in these metro applications. So why it is used? The main reason is due to these capacitors. Okay, so in metro, right, we have frequent stoppages, right? For every kilometer or every half kilometer, you have stop, right? So that means when you are trying to stop the induction machine, right? So Lord, we need to apply some regeneration, right? So that means the regeneration is right. That means the regeneration is happening so quickly. So when you have these capacitors, so this capacitor, whatever that energy, right, whatever that energy that is available during that regeneration, so that are used to store the that are stored in this capacitor at a faster rate, right? The capacitor quickly charges, right? This capacitor quickly takes this energy, so that, and it will gradually feed to the AC bus, and it is gradually feed to the AC system at the source side. Okay, when you have capacitor, the charging and discharging is happening at a faster rate. So therefore, in case of regenerative, so heat efficiency will be increased. So due to this reason, normally in metro applications, especially these when you have frequent stoppages, so where a lot of energy is wasted in the form of braking, right? So in that case, whatever that energy is there during that regeneration, that is absorbed by these capacitors. Okay, so capacitors having a property to slightly overcharge that, right, and retain that overcharge, whatever that retain, and it will feed back to the source, whatever that amount of energy stored in the capacitors, right? So that is feeding back to the source at a high efficiency. Okay, so overall drive efficiency will be increases, right? So apart from that, these metro applications, right, so there is no actually practical applications are there. Okay, clear? So that is about this flying capacitor multi-link inverter. The drawback with this one is we need to pre-charge these capacitors and we need to maintain these capacitor voltages. So that is the difficult task. Okay. Next one is these are the hybrid configurations, right? So can anyone guess what is this one? So these are the hybrid configurations. What is this? Can anyone guess? So what is this one? What is this?
Cascaded heat bridge. Cascaded heat
bridge. Diode clamps. Only this encircled one.
Diode clamps. Diode clamps.
Diode clamp, right? So this is a single phase, right? This is a single phase diode clamp, right? So this is also single case, a single phase diode clamp. So earlier one, in case of cascaded bridge, we are cascaded H bridges. Okay, so we are cascaded H bridges. So now we are cascaded single phase diode clamped inverter or single phase NPC. Okay, so now we are cascaded the single phase NPC. Right, so the same structure earlier one. So that is the cascade connection of H bridges. So this is simple, it's a cascade connection of NPC. Right, so here also E voltage is there. E voltage is there, right? So that means the total voltage, it will vary from E to E, 0, minus E and minus 2E. The structure will provide 5 levels. Okay, so this is a cascade connection of single phase diode clamp multi-level, right? This is the cascade connection of single phase diode clamp, right? If you have another one, just you can cascade this one, just cascade this another NPC here, and we can cascade this, so that we can increase the levels, right? For example, if I cascade another NPC of the same structure, so how many levels you can get? How many levels you will get with that? The same structure, this is one single phase, NPC is in cascade connection, right? If two NPCs are in cascade, how many levels you will get?
Seven levels.
If you have two, right? If you have one more, right? So that means another one is having two sources, right? So that is E and 2E. So that means total how many sources? So this is top one, the top NPC, you have two sources, and the bottom NPC, you have another two sources, right? So that means four sources. That means four sources, right? So that means how many levels you will get? So 0E, 2E, 3E, and 4E, right? That means you will five levels. That means so you will get 9 levels, right? Okay. So that entire structure will gives you 9 levels starting from 4E to minus 4E. So don't be confused with this. Right. So earlier we have this H bridge, right? H bridge with one DC source. So now what I did is I replaced this one with single phase NPC, which is having two sources. One is E and another one is E. That means two sources, right? So similarly, this bottom is also single phase NPC that is also having two sources. This is E and E, right? That means this will produce 2E, E0 minus 2E and minus E, right? So this is also produced 2E. This will produce 2E, E0 minus E and minus 2E. So the combined output will vary from plus 4E to minus 4E, right? You agree? It's clear?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Okay. So that is how the cascading of different modules or different modules to increase the number of levels with a fewer components. Yeah. So now, may not understand at this point, right? So this is the same one, right? This is same. This is when you have power is extremely high. Okay, we will discuss in later class. Okay, right. So this is also I will discuss in later classes, right? Don't be confused with that. This is normally especially used for the powers. If a motor drive of rating 100 megawatt. Right, 100 megawatt range motor drives. If you have some projects are there, right? If you consider the, you have one project is there in Telangana, right? That is Kaleshwaram project. So where they have used the motors that are rated up to 64 megawatt range. Okay, the motor range is 64 megawatt. In case of steel mills, in that case also the motor ratings are very high. So it is around 100 megawatt motor you required. Okay. 100 megawatt motor you require. So that means that's too high, right? So in that case, so how the converter is look like, this is one of the example. This is used in some Japan steel industry. This is used in Japan's steel industry. So here each, right, this is A phase, B phase, C phase, right? This is B phase and this is C phase. This entire thing is A phase, okay? This entire thing is A phase. So each A phase having a three phase cascade H bridge inverter. Okay, that means each A phase you have one cascade H bridge inverter of someone. So this is in B phase you have another one and C phase you have another one. So that means it's simple to understand. A phase and similar structure for C phase. Okay, so this is how to increase the power levels. So this is how to increase the power levels when you have exceptionally large rating is required. This is known as TSBC, that is the triple star bridge cells. Triple star bridge cells. Okay, A phase you have one star connection, B phase you have another star connection, and C phase here another star connection, right? Three stars means you have three star connections, right? In A and B and C. So that is known as triple star bridge cell converter. This is used in induction motor, especially for larger ratings, right? So in that case, the power range is usually 100 megawatt range. Okay, so this is already there in industry. One Japan steel mill is there. So in that case, in that they used this. Okay. We will these are these inductors, coupled inductors. Right, we'll discuss this about when you actually discuss, right? So this is the comparison of all what we discussed. Okay, so far we studied three topologies, right? One is the neutral point clamped, so that is also known as a diode clamped multi-level inverter, and we have this flying capacitor multi-level inverter. This SSBC, so that is other name for this is CHB. The other name for CHB is SSBC, right? Single star bridge cells. So this is the main switching devices you already discussed. It requires 2 into M minus 1 diode IGBTs are required. So along with 2 into M minus 1 anti-parallel diodes. Okay. It is same to all. So this anti-parallel and the main switches, it is same to all. And the clamping diodes, it requires M minus 1 into M minus 2 clamping diodes are required. So whereas in flying capacitors, clamping diodes are not required, right? In case of CHB also, this clamping diodes are not required. In case of DC buses, right, we have four M-1 DC sources are required. So here also M-1 DC sources are required. In case of CHB, you require M-1/2 DC sources you required. Okay. So additional thing is, in case of NPC, these flying capacitors are not required. So these are only required in this flying capacitor topology, right? Only required is FC-MLI. Clear? This is only required in FC-MLI. So from this, right? So from this, which device require a less cost? Which is less cost device? Can you expect? Which devices? Or which topology is having less cost?
Right? THB.
CHB, right? In case of CHB or cascade H bridge, right? So you don't require this clamping diodes. Okay, you don't require this clamping diodes, right? And you don't require these flying capacitors. Okay, and moreover, the number of DC sources, earlier it is my M-1 in case of MPC and FC, right? So it is only M-1/2. Anyway, the switchings are same for all, right? So that means CHB cost is less. So when compared to other two, okay? So when compared to these other two, cost of CHB is less. Okay? Clear? So now you have, if you have three level, right? If you have three level, right? So one thing you need to remember, right? So this is for all phases. This is for all phases. And whereas this one is per phase. This is for per phase. Okay. So that means in case of three level, you require two DC sources here. Right, you require two DC sources in case of NPC. In case of flying capacitor, you require two DC sources for all phases. In case of CHB, so that is three level, right? 3-1, that is one, right? So that means one per phase. That means overall you require two. So that is two in case of diode clamp. In case of flying capacitor, you require two, and in case of CHB, you require three. If you're talking about three phase, similarly, in case of five level, you require four in diode clamp and four in flying capacitor. So how many you require in cascade edge bridge for overall three phase? How many you require in case of five level? Each phase you require two, right? So that is total is six. Okay, so total is six DC sources you required. So therefore, so there is some trade-off, right? There is some trade-off in the lower levels. In case of levels 3, 4, 5, right? In case of levels 3, 4, 5, this neutral point clamped or this flying capacitor is slightly cheaper. In case of 3, 4, 5, this neutral point clamped or this flying capacitor is slightly cheaper. But in case of higher levels, greater than 5 levels, so this CHB or this cascade edge bridge is cheaper. Okay, this cascade edge bridge is cheaper because of fewer components. Clear? So wherever this one, this clamping diodes are gradually increases, right? If you have 5 levels and if you go for 7 levels, right? So this value will be gradually high and it will cost a lot when compared to CHB. So what we conclude that in case of lower power range, that means in case of 3, 4, and 5 level, so usually this diode clamp is cheaper, a flying capacitor is cheaper, but higher levels greater than 5, so this cascade edge bridge is cheaper, right? So this is the overall comparison, so point by point comparison. So one is the specific requirement. Specific requirement, so diode clamped, it requires clamping diodes, that is a specific requirement. In case of flying capacitor, you require some additional capacitors and their initialization. So meaning of initialization is to pre-charge, okay? So that is to pre-charge these capacitors. And what is the CHB? It requires isolated DC sources. Isolated DC sources. So next point is modularity. So what is modularity means? Meaning is, right, so here, right, so here, you're constructed one inverter, right? For example, you're constructed an inverter for 2.3 kV. So assume that you are constructed some inverter for 2.3 kV. In future, right, maybe after 2 years or 3 years, so you observe that this 2.3 kV or this power range is not sufficient, okay? This power range is not sufficient. I want to increase it to maybe from 6.6 kV. Okay, I want to increase this to 6.6 kV or higher range, right? So in that case, so in this case, just we need to add, increase this power range, right? So that means we need to add some additional modules, or we need to add some additional modules for this. Okay, so in case of, if you assume that if this inverter, what you took earlier, right? So that means if you assume that that is built with cascade edge bridge, so how to increase the power range of this one? How to increase the power range of this one? It is simple, right? If you want to increase its range, right? So add one more H bridge. Okay. So now it is six H bridges are in cascade, right? If you want to increase it to a higher voltage, right? So add another one, right? So add another H bridge or another, if you keep on adding, right? So here adding of each H bridge is easy. Okay. So that is easy, is easily scalable to higher levels, because the structure is modular. Okay, the structure is modular. If you add one H bridge right here, so this operation is not right, this operation, there is no need to change anything here, right? You just remove this connection and add another one and remove this connection, right? Just removal of connection to increase the number of levels, right? Okay, so that means CHB is modular in structure. So that means it is scalability. So when you want to increase its levels in the future, so it is, you can easily do that. Or if you want to remove that, so you can easily do that. So without disturbing the earlier one. So that means modularity is very high. Okay. In case of other one, we have this diode clamper. So in case of this diode clamp, right, so see, I have three phase structure is there, okay? So I have some existing three phase structure is there. So I want to make it to four level, okay? So if you want to make it to four level, you need to add another device here, right? Okay? So add another device here. We have top unity add one device and bottom unity add another device, right? So this is okay. But what about this clamping diodes? Okay. How about this clamping diodes? Again, the rating of this clamping diodes, right? So when you add another device, right, we already discussed this, right? So this rating is changed, right? Earlier it is D1, and this is now we need to add another diode in series with that existing one, right? If you want to make it this 4, so you need to add this much of diodes. So therefore, so this is less modular. That means if you want to increase this rating, so we need to entirely change this structure, right? We need to entirely change this structure. This is less modular. So whereas this flying capacitor, right? So this is flying capacitor structure, right? For example, if you want to increase that, right, if you want to increase that, you just add another cell here, right? You have to add another cell, that is cell 4. Okay, cell 4, again, there is no change in the switch point of view, right? You had another switch here, so you can name this as S4. You can name this as S4, right? And now this will be the X. Okay, now this will be the X and this will be the cell 4. But this voltage we need to replace with a capacitor. This is E now. This is 2E and this is 3E. Okay, this is E, 2E and 3E. Right, so this is also modular, but when you compare with CHB, its modularity is medium. Okay, this modularity in between this diode clamped and CHB. Okay, so in case of diode clamped, we need to change the entire inverter. Okay, we need to do a lot of modifications. In case of CHB, we need to do the least modifications, but in case of this flying capacitors, so modularity is high, but we need to do some minimal changes. Okay, so that's why its modularity is low here, and this is high, and this is very high. You understand this point? So next one is the design and its complexity. Because of this flying this layered clamp, its complexity is low. Okay, design complexity is somewhat low, right? And this inverter, this is a medium because we need to precharge this one, right? So therefore it is medium, and this is least. Okay, this construction of the CHB is least, but there is one condition is there. Okay, the drawback with CHB is it cannot provide the real power transfers, right? If you want real power transfer, you need to connect some transformer, multiples arrangement, right? Okay. So we need to connect some multiples arrangement that we already discussed, that is 16, 18 pulse or 12 pulse, we need to connect, right? So in that case, its difficulty is high. So when you have the transformer is not there, right? So in that case, it is least. That means it is extremes, both extremes, right? So when the application is, right, when the application is demanding only capacitors as an isolated sources, so in that case, its construction is easy, right? Its construction easy. Whereas if it is a real power demand is expected, that is when you are using it a motor drive, so in that case, it is very difficult. Clear? So control concern, so that is balancing, voltage balancing of the two DC sources. So that is difficult, that we will discuss. So this voltage setup, so that is initialization is difficult. So this is power sharing, right? That is power sharing of each H bridge. We already discussed, right? One H bridge will normally underutilized, one is overutilized, right? So we need to equalize that. So that is the main thing in here. So fault tolerance. So fault tolerance is there any fault in one module, one H bridge, for example, right? So how to operate with the remaining one? So in case of diode clamp, it's difficult because of this fault tolerance and modularity, both are right. When the structure is modular, in that case, the fault tolerance is easy. Okay, all these things we'll discuss, right? So this case of flying capacitor, it is easy. In case of CHB also, it is easy because we can easily control the whenever once H-bridge is faulty, we can easily control the rest, right? So these are the applications. So that is used in custom power devices. Custom power devices, that means STATCOM, DSTATCOM, adjustable speed drives, that is motor drives, conveyors, marine applications, and regenerative applications such as mining and renewable energy, right? So in case of flying capacitors, its applications are limited, especially in traction drive applications, medium voltage traction drive applications. Whereas the CHB, its applications are vast. It can be used in FACTS, custom power devices. We'll discuss what is custom power device. High power adjustable speed drives, electric and hybrid electric vehicles, PV conversion, uninterrupted power supplies, magnetic image, right? That is MRI scanning is there, right? That is used for medical applications, right? In case of MRI, you require high magnetic intensity that is provided by the high voltage up in the range of 75 kV volts you require. Okay. So in such high voltage is obtained by from your normal voltage, okay, normal 440 volts, right? So that is obtained by using this cascade H-bridge. Normally for all these X-ray machines or this magnetic resonance images, normally operate at 75 kilovolts. Such high voltage is obtained by the by using this cascade H-bridge inverter, right? So coming to this cost, generally its cost, as we discussed, its cost is low for 3-level or 4-level, right? And its cost is medium, slightly costly than this flying capacitor. So whereas CHB, again, there are two extreme for this, right? When you have this transformer kind of arrangement, that is for, if you use it for motor drive, it's very costly, right? If you use this for a motor drive, it is very costly because of that front end multipulse converter. And if you use it for other applications like FACTS or PV or hybrid electric drives or electric vehicles, and its cost is very low. Okay, clear? So these are the commercial available range. This is normally available in the voltage range of 2.3 to 6.6 kV with MVA range of up to 44 MVA. So whereas this is generally available for low voltage range. And this is, we have applications up to 120 MVA rating. So these inverters are normally, we have applications of 120 MVA. Okay. So generally CHB, right? So the cost of CHB and complexity of CHB, that all depends on the applications. So when it is a motor drive application, you see it is very complex. Okay. So when it is applications like FACTS, active power conversion, or UPS applications, or any magnetic resonance image applications, in that case, its cost is very less. Okay. Just give me 5 minutes, I will complete this. So this is the applications, what are different manufacturers and with along with their products. Okay, so this is ABB, and we have Convertim, Siemens, and we have Indic Drive and TMEIC GE. This is GE, and this is 3-level NPC and 3-level ANPC. We'll discuss this, what is ANPC. So that is the modified version of NPC. The diodes are replaced with IGBTs with anti-parallel diodes. So that is known as active neutral point clamp. So that we will discuss. And we have Alstom, right? So this Alstom companies, this is the provider for this metro, Delhi metro, and this Hyderabad metro and several Mumbai metro, right? So this is power converters and motor drives. So that is supplied by the Alstom. So in that case, they used this flying capacitor multi-level inverters, that is VDM600. So this is the popular one. Okay, that is used in metro applications. And we have other, that is CHB. We have Siemens, Hitachi, and Schneider, and Roxing Power, and Rockwell, and some companies are there. This is what is the switching they are used, that is IGBT or IGCT, a medium voltage IGBT, and some applications they are used. Okay, and some they are used also GCT, they are used, that is gate controlled thyristor, right? So these are different manufacturer along with their product range in case of medium and high power applications. Okay, is clear? If you have any doubts on this, so we just completed the introduction this multi-level inverter. So next class we will see in depth. We'll study in depth of these topologies. If any doubts on this, you can ask me now. Have any doubts on this? I should stop here. Any doubts on this? Tell me first.
No sir.
Okay then, we'll wind up here and we'll discuss in the next class.
Okay sir.
Thank you sir.
Okay.